What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well on this Thursday evening, April 4th. Spring is officially here, although it hasn't made its way to Northeast Ohio yet. I can't believe it. Yeah, I'm sure you were. So this is unbelievably, I noticed our 121st episode. They just keep piling up. So we're happy you joined us. Got a great show planned for you tonight. I'm Rob Bertrand. That guy over there is Ivan Lovgren. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome aboard. Sit back, strap it in, and get ready for at least an hour's worth of fun tonight. We've got some...
In fact, I'd argue if you're joining us for the first time, in whatever chat room you're at, tell us how you heard about us, because that would be fun. Fun to see.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've got a GoGTS Live Q of the Week poll going, courtesy of the asset, James Gale, behind the scenes, technical director, producer, whatever. I can't keep up with his all he does. He's just like freaking miracle worker isn't like an official title. So
we tried to give it to him, but we got sued by the Helen Keller people.
We have a busy sports weekend ahead of us, as everybody knows. So what are you most excited to watch? The Final Four, WrestleMania, the NHL NBA playoff races being finalized, or Major League Baseball? And 39% of you said Major League Baseball. Baseball started already?
Yeah. Like two of these.
What?
I mean, come on.
College basketball and wrestling?
Yeah. What's up with that? Let's talk about sports, Rob. Let's not talk about, you know, some the second tier athletes in a being forced to play a year of college basketball just because the powers that be.
You know what? I'm so glad you said that. Crazy, because it proves exactly how ignorant you are. Do you realize that this is the first time in several years that each of the Final Four teams does not have a one and done player? And that's why it was so great to see the likes of Kansas, Kentucky, and Duke bow out.
Except that it also means that we're not seeing the absolute best players. So, and then WrestleMania, I won't spoil it for you, Rob, but so I could argue the NHL NBA playoff races, but they just don't do it for me like Major League Baseball. So I was with the 39%, Rob. For once, I'm not in the minority on a poll.
Baseball.
That's only because you're a White
baseball
Sox fan.
Baseball shouldn't even start until after the Stanley Cup is over. Everybody knows that.
Well, that's because both seasons are far too long. The first day of spring is when the hockey season should be over, and the baseball season shouldn't start until after the first day of spring, which is exactly how it goes.
Baseball is like the soundtrack of summer, so technically it shouldn't even start until the first day of summer. Right.
Told you I was sweating today. It was 80 degrees here.
They should shorten that season down to like 100 games. That would be way more interesting to me.
No, they should keep it at the number of games that it's at, but we need literally more double headers. Bring it on. We're paying these guys
in this age of specialization, right? I mean, there's enough pitchers on a roster. Expand the rosters to 50 players.
Uh-huh.
You know, baseball, whatever. I'll pay attention to baseball when I can warm up my grill. All right. So now that I've pissed off 40% of you, I'll tell you what else we have going on tonight. Hobby happenings. Box breaks of the X-Files, UFOs, Alien, UFO. Wait, what is this called? 2019 Upper Deck, the X-Files, UFOs, and Aliens trading cards. Okay. And then 2019 Panini Stars and Stripes Baseball. And then I think Chris Carlin forgot that he had already sent me Marvel Annual.
Ooh, so
we're gonna give a whole box away. We're just going to give a sealed box away of Marvel Annual tonight.
Yeah, I like that. Well, hey, real quick, if you are watching and you just heard about the poll question, so that poll question is on Twitter, GoGTS Live on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. Make sure that you answer the poll question. Make sure that you retweet our pinned tweet, which is actually the live broadcast through Twitter, so that maybe some more of your friends can go see it. And make sure you follow us there, because we're going to be giving away hits from those boxes that we open. And those hits are going to be given away through Twitter. So while we love you subscribing on Twitch, we love you watching on Facebook, live stream, YouTube, make sure that you go follow us on Twitter too. Yeah, that's all I got. That's logistics. And we're going to argue some more about what real sports are sports.
Well, I will be in East Rutherford, New Jersey this Sunday attending WrestleMania, as well as the Topps WWE Transcendent Experience. So I'm excited about that. Hopefully I'll be able to bring back some content for you guys.
Rob, you ripped off some sores, and I got to side with guys. Sorry, the chat is popping off already. And I wanted to say this, but I was going to be nice on you. But come on, what do you mean when you can fire up the grill? Pabst Beer 8, who lives just down the street from you somewhere in East Northern Illinois, says, wait, you don't grill when it's cold? Nope. I grill when it's snowing. And then Jimmy Bayless, who lives in Michigan, which I know is further north than you, also said, I'm already grilling and I live up here in Michigan. Come on, good, Rob.
Good for you.
Better
good
arguments.
Good for you.
Bears fan.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. I would rather watch, and Rat Python sounded off on the Twitter poll and said it's got to be WrestleMania because Chicago Blackhawks aren't in the playoffs. I know. As a Hawks fan, I'm hurting too, but here's the fact of the matter. I would rather watch any NHL playoff game than any of my teams in baseball play this early in the season. That's the way it is.
I'm just enjoying the rarity of Rob being the punching bag, because for those of you that are a little newer, my middle name is Punching Bag. That's sort of my role. So
that's all right. Everybody's allowed to be wrong.
How does it feel, Rob? How does it feel?
You know me. I could give a crap.
I should actually ask your wife if this is a regular occurrence or not.
What?
You being wrong.
Oh, well, of course, ask anybody's wife. Come on, you've been married long enough to know that.
Yeah, thankfully, I don't live near Chicago, so hopefully you won't be able to ask my wife in person at the National this year. But I'm going to get yours on the record.
She won't be there.
Oh, you're not bringing...
I doubt my wife would take off of work, but the kids might stay at Grandma and Grandpa's.
That'd be fun. My grandma is somewhere near Chicago, but
I don't have access to all these commentaries going on. Let me hear some of them.
All you got to do is open up your Facebook, and you can see Randa Bechtel being like, "Ha ha! I grill in the snow too." LMAO. Do you know what that stands for, Rob?
Yeah.
Literally at you. James Campino saying, come on, Chicago, tailgating at Bears games in the snow is a rite of passage. Sacrilege. Baseball is just fine the way it is. Jeffrey Groton chimes in. This is all from Facebook. Pabst Beer, he's showing up with his wife at the National. It's his 7th year wedding anniversary. He's going to be celebrating at the National. I don't know if that's his call out, but good for you. Pabst, congrats on the new house. I just saw you got that right there. Barbas716 simply says, I am in Buffalo. We've seen too that funny. Lake effect there much, much worse than the lake effect anywhere else in America. I think
oh my gosh,
gonna have the final word on that.
Yeah, no doubt. So, well, and you guys are much more manly than I am, apparently. So
hey, not all manly. Shout out to BethLynn16, who just subscribed for the 2nd month in a row, and I'm sure is also ready to grill. So
standing out there, you know, when it's cold, grilling. Yeah. I used to do that. You know, it's true. I used to do that when I drank more. Because, you know, the martini keeps you warm, you know? You
get Rob, that you're flush making it feeling. Too easy. Wait, the martini? You're out in the snow grilling and drinking a martini? Come on.
Yeah, what you know, I this? Mean, that's my pre-dinner go-to. I don't want to fill up on beer and then eat. Yeah, I don't roll like that. What else you got? Is that it?
Well, I just wanted to give Barbas the final word because I know we do have
a show. I thought I was being a punching bag. Come on.
You were. I mean, I could open YouTube and see what they were saying there. It's all over. It's all over, Rob. We have a show to do.
You know what? It's my show. I could shut this down right now and not do anything. How about them apples? You like that?
You actually, I think it's technically James's show. I think that he could be the one. Remember, we gave him all that power.
Yeah, we did, didn't we?
Yeah. Beans ball card. I use my grill and smoker year round here in Texas. Well, of course. But Grady Malachowski, I grill out all winter in caps. In caps.
All right. Well, here's what I want you to do. You have taken 10 commenters, and it's stopped right now. Those 10 commenters, I want you to write down. Okay.
Okay. This is gonna be.
They.
You were counting?
It seemed like about that.
Okay.
Those are the ones that are going to be eligible for the sealed box of Marvel Annual.
Oh, wow. Okay.
See, I just get everybody fired up.
All right, so, hey, do me a favor so that I can actually do something random with that.
Mm-hmm. What do you need, bro?
Well, no, telling them, make sure you go and retweet the pinned Periscope tweet. The pinned Periscope tweet on the Twitter, because then I'm just going to click the tweet draw button until I see one of these names. But let me go back through and just make sure that I didn't miss anybody because I'm only at Jimmy Bayless. I got to get him on here.
So, yeah, listen to Ivan.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
also,
7.
Remarkably,
who else said something good?
Possibly our biggest hit from last week, the Kyrie Irving auto and the accompanying insert from Cornerstones Basketball went unclaimed.
Wow.
So we'll be giving that away tonight, too.
Okay, so a little bonus giveaway. So that will also be through retweeting the Periscope tweet on Twitter. That's the way to. Who else did I shout out? Was there anyone? Barbas, Shane, Paps, Jimmy, Randa, Beth Lynn. Did I say what James Campano said? I wanted to because he had like 17. He said Peach Crown Royal keeps you warm. I did when I
see liquor. Liquor keeps you warm, not beer. Apparently, if it does, I was doing it wrong.
I guess they have vodka in Siberia, so maybe.
Right, exactly.
And then Jeffrey Groton. All right, so I got a list of names for that. And then we've got that bonus giveaway. So everybody make sure that you go ahead and retweet the pinned tweet on Twitter. It's a Periscope broadcast. It is the show live. Give us some hearts if you're watching that. If you're watching on Facebook, you can just give us some emotes right there, some emojis. If you're watching on Twitch, you can do those little click bits down below. You can actually pay for a click bit, or you can just do one of the free ones. Not quite sure how they work. I just click a bunch of buttons. Pretty awesome stuff. Beans, yep, Beans, you're on there. You're on there. Brew Crew fan Jeff, sadly, I didn't get to actually say yours out loud.
Oh, throw him on there.
I was just going to say, I'm at 9 names, so he gets on there too. But it is cut off.
All right. Those 10 are eligible.
But you see, this is why it pays to engage. So we love the conversation. We love, hey, Terry Deck is actually. And I know that you're struggling right now. Terry just started cancer treatment, so shout out to him. Terry, thanks for making it in. That's some strength right there. So Well, Rob, I think the show must go on. It's your show, so I'll leave it up to you to say that. But
good night, everybody. We'll be back next week.
All right. Nothing happened in the hobby this week. Nothing's in the shop next week.
I'm kidding. I love you guys. And I like baseball. There's so much else going on right now. All right. So, yeah, let's check out what is happening in the hobby in a segment we like to call, believe it or not, Hobby Happenings. So first up, some business news. If you're watching the show, it's probably safe to say that you at least periodically, once in a while, sell on eBay. Chances are also pretty good that if you do, you accept payment through PayPal. Well, if both of these criteria are true, you may want to rethink your current refund policy. Reason being is that e-commerce Bytes is reporting that PayPal's updated user agreement states that, quote, "We're changing how we treat refunds. If you refund partially or fully a transaction to a buyer or donation to a donor, there are fees to make the refund, but the fees you originally paid as the seller will not be returned to you." See, in the past, PayPal retained the 30-cent processing fee, but returned the percentage part of the fee to you. Well, now if a seller issues a refund, PayPal is keeping 100% of the total processing fee. So what does this mean exactly? It means if you sell a card for $100, have to issue a refund, you are automatically out $3.20, not the 30 cents it was previously. So even though eBay wants you to offer free returns, I'm not a fan of just giving money away. And since they did away with their restocking fee option, you either have to eat the loss or not offer returns and suffer the search result consequences.
Bring on those consequences.
Exactly.
Between the 1920s and 1950s, arcade machines like this dotted the boardwalks of Coney Island, Atlantic City, and other promenades of entertainment. We all miss them. We all love them. They were manufactured by the Exhibit Supply Company and contained, you guessed it, some of the very exhibit cards many collectors are familiar with today. So imagine the surprise of one coin-operated machine collector who recently purchased this pair of machines and upon opening discovered over 400 cards in mint condition. In addition to TV cowboys and other pop culture figures of the era, the majority of the cards were of notable baseball and football players. For more information and further details about 1953 ESCO exhibit cards, check out the recent article on Sports Collectors Digest.
100 years ago, the national pastime experienced its darkest hour, the Black Sox World Series scandal of 1919. Say it ain't so, Joe. Pictured here is one of only two known tickets to the deciding Game 8, and the only one in the PSA population report. It's being offered in an upcoming sale through Heritage Auctions and carries an estimated value of over $5,000, which I think is absolutely going to be blown away.
That's I would take the over if that were being offered too. In a sports book somewhere. The market for unopened vintage and even retro era material is red hot, thanks in no small part to the success of vintagebreaks.com. Just how many unopened packs and boxes remain in hiding throughout the country is still a mystery. However, nearly 100 lots are coming to market through Heritage Auctions. Highlights include yet another 86-87 Fleer basketball box with a coveted MJ rookie card, a box of 1984 Topps football that should yield multiple rookie cards of Dan Marino and John Elway, and a very rare 1968 Topps Series 1 football box, just to name a few. See all of the jaw-dropping wax up for grabs on the Heritage Auctions website.
It's crazy to think that the groundbreaking baseball card set that was is and always will be 1989 Upper Deck Baseball is 30 years old this year. It's also interesting to look back and see what made the set so game-changing and what attributes were becoming more important to collectors and how Upper Deck would set the bar for all future baseball card releases in the years that followed. Many of the characteristics we take for granted today are printed as selling points right on the box. An insert in every pack, perception of limited and high-quality production, more cards per pack, anti-counterfeiting technology, better collation, tamper-proof foil as opposed to wax packaging. So let's all raise a glass to Richard McWilliams on this, the 30th anniversary of Upper Deck baseball cards.
Limited edition.
Yeah, right?
The acclaimed artwork of baseball historian Greg Crindler, will be featured at times throughout the release of this year's 150 Years of Baseball progressive set from Topps. Craig teased this work in progress on his Twitter account, and we can't wait to see how the final version is used.
Yeah, maybe we could get him on the show. Well, farewell and rest in peace, Alliance of American Football League. We hardly knew thee.
It was so exciting while it lasted.
However, in all seriousness, the recently released AAF set from Topps is one of the only, if not the only, place to find some rare autographs of some prominent football coaches, including Rick Neuheisel, who coached for the Ravens, Chargers, and Buccaneers, and in college, UCLA, Colorado, Buffalo, Dennis Erickson of the 49ers and Seahawks, and perhaps best known, Mike Martz, who served as the offensive coordinator for the Rams' greatest show on turf offense in 1999 that led the franchise to its first Super Bowl title in Super Bowl 34 over the Tennessee Titans.
I didn't have time to research this. I'm still convinced Dennis Erickson may be in 1991 or 92 pro line.
He might be. Good point. But
You didn't say exclusive, though, or only, right. But chance to chase them. Also cool that there were some of the female assistant coaches who were sort of groundbreaking as well. Their autographs were in that product, and you can still chase them. All right, other exciting hobby happenings this week. Well, if you have always said, I want the hobby to look like this, or, hey, I need a job, there are more jobs in the hobby available that we're going to announce right now. You're about out of excuses, in fact, because now Gray Flannel Auctions, headquartered in the Scottsdale, Phoenix, Arizona area, is hiring. The premium auction house is looking for a listing assistant. Doesn't sound like something you can say, oh, I'm not qualified for that, as well as a product photographer. So if you're a good photographer, reach out to them. Go get a hobby job already. No complaints, no excuses.
Isn't this pretty? Let's just gaze at its beauty for a moment. In a move long overdue, Panini America's put the pedal to the metal with a full car sponsorship of Xfinity Series driver Gray Galding, who races the number 8 Chevy Camaro. He'll race in Saturday's Alsco 300 at the historic Bristol Motor Speedway inside a Panini-themed car. Panini America Vice President of Marketing Jason Hauer said, we've made a concerted effort to put more marketing power behind our NASCAR business this season. And this partnership is a result of that commitment. Congrats, guys, on an exciting and bold marketing spend. Can't wait to see the diecast version of that.
Ryan Cracknell at Beckett Media is reporting that one of the most iconic baseball cards of all time from that same 30-year-old set is getting its own bobblehead. The Seattle Mariners will pay tribute to the groundbreaking 1989 Upper Deck Ken Griffey Jr. rookie card with a bobblehead giveaway on May 18th. And even though the mock-ups so far have only been two-dimensional, I can't wait to see what it actually looks like. A total of 20,000 of the 1989 Upper Deck-inspired Ken Griffey Jr. Rookie Year bobbleheads will be handed out. So if you plan on attending, get there early.
And if you visited the Beckett website this week, you may have noticed a small call-out in the navigation bar for a new service. Sports Collectors Daily reports in a detailed article that Beckett Authentication Services is launching a low-cost online review feature. Beckett Signature Review will allow customers to share a link or photo of an autograph that hasn't been authenticated by the company. For a cost of $10, a Beckett Authenticator will review the item and offer their opinion on whether the item would likely pass the full authentication process. The determination is sent to the customer by email within 24 to 48 hours, sometimes less. PSA currently offers a similar quick opinion service for items strictly offered by eBay sellers. This service was specifically designed for people looking to make an autograph purchase at a show, hobby shop, or other real-world venues and not strictly online. In addition, it's being integrated into the app, which will speed response time sometimes while you're at the show with the item in front of you. Be sure to check out the full article on sportscollectorsdaily.com for more details.
Beginning tomorrow at noon Central Time, set your clocks, set your watches, and set your phones. The next wave of Prism White Sparkles arrive exclusively at iCollectPanini.com. The popular 2018-19 Prism White Sparkle basketball release is a 300-card set, 250 base cards, 50 rookie cards that will be distributed via 3-card packs while supplies last. In addition to showcasing the standout members of the talented 2018 NBA draft class, packs will include randomly inserted rookie autographs limited to only one. Customers will be limited to just 5 packs per transaction, and the packs will only be available while supplies last.
There was no mention in that report of what packs cost. Does anybody know from past experience? So I'm just trying to do some quick math. Even with perfect collation, you're going to have to buy a minimum of 100 packs to complete that set.
It could be pricey.
Wow. All right. Sparkly. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Anything you want to unpack from there? Pretty straightforward?
Yeah, I mean, pretty straightforward. It'll be exciting to see some of those things at the, you know, go to Heritage Auctions and see that. And like I mentioned, the Griffey, I've only seen like an announcement pretty much, not really what the actual bobblehead itself will look like. So that's what I want to see. Will it actually have a frame to honor the Upper Deck card, or will it just be like his picture from that card? That's what I want to see. And of course, I know that we tweeted or we texted a little bit before that about the Alliance of American Football League and the information. I really am bummed because there were a lot of guys that not only myself, but our friends and followers collected when they were in the NFL that were getting a second shot.
Like Trent Richardson?
Yeah, Trent Richardson.
Johnny Manziel?
Johnny Manziel, in fact, had just joined the league, and then it goes ahead and folds from what a lot of people are saying is some...
What I do not understand, number one, you would think that a new league that starts would have the funding to get through the first season. Number two, I know there was a cash infusion like after the second game. Mm-hmm. That seems like the whole thing was mismanaged from the absolute very beginning get-go.
Well, from what I gathered, like, did you read up on some of the like reasons for it?
No, I can only speculate that viewership numbers weren't there, and so the share of TV revenue.
So it wasn't even that. It was Tom Dundon is the name of the guy. He owns the Carolina Hurricanes as well.
Right. He's the one who put all the cash in.
he essentially just pulled out and said like his portion was done and that was enough to fold it. So they had enough, but he was very much like, hey, if we don't get a deal to be the developmental league for the NFL, like, then I'm going to pull it. And they didn't get a deal.
Wow, that's too bad, because that would be a good thing for football, I think. I think there's a lot of players that just need a little bit more seasoning, you know?
Well, not only that, it seemed to be popular. People continued to watch. So he was the majority owner.
So he just took his ball and went home. That's basically
pretty much, and ruined
what
the league.
What a jerk.
Yep.
What a jerk. Yeah. Oh, man, how can anybody root for the Carolina Panthers anymore? No, yeah, I'm talking to you. Let me. Oh, Hurricanes.
Yeah.
The Hurricanes. Jeez. Yep.
So
it's brutal, man.
Yep.
And, so I wonder how that works. Does Topps get any of their licensing feedback? Probably not. I mean, do you think they might have had the foresight to negotiate something like that? Like if the league folds, you know, before the season is halfway through, they get partial refund, or I'm always curious how things like that work in the business side of things. Probably not. Probably they just hoped for, you know, and make whatever they could. And if it came back, so be it. I don't know.
I would have to imagine. Cause I mean, they did get to sell, product. They sold Topps Now cards, involved with that. But, that guy Hugs pointing out, and I had read this as well, that Rep Diaz, I'm conflating two people with green names in the thing, original intention was that deal would get done in 3 years, and then Tom Dundon just sort of out of nowhere, because they literally, like, the day before were tweeting about their playoffs were starting the next week, and then that day
playoffs, like, we're talking about playoffs.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. So all right, well, so much for that. I wonder what that means for the XFL. Well, we definitely know that there's deeper pockets behind that.
Do we? Is Vince McMahon richer than Tom Dundon?
Oh, I would almost guarantee it. Dude, you have no idea the machine and the monolith that is the WWE from a money-making perspective. Unless that guy's, you know, unless he's got a side hustle, this Dundon dude or whatever, you know, or he's like an oil baron or something. Anyway, who wants to open some product?
Well, Vince is three times richer than him.
Yeah.
Only 3.3 billion to 1.1 billion, though.
Yeah. Like I said, I didn't even need to look that up, dude.
And that's actually not counting the value of the Carolina Hurricanes. That's just counting the value of his stock and his company.
All right, kicking things off in our live box break segment tonight, we have new from Upper Deck, the X-Files, UFOs and Aliens. This is the first of what are supposed to be a three-product release, each focusing on a different theme of the show. And you weren't listening. Why do I bother? No, I said that beforehand, before we even did that. And it's on the show notes.
I somehow muted my thing, even though I don't know how Rob heard me, because I had actually muted my mic. That's really strange. It's all weird. It's not in the show notes.
Yeah, it is. So X-Files, UFOs, and Aliens. Look for autographs, premium inserts, and sketch cards.
Marvel Annual.
Oh, look at that.
Well, box giveaway doesn't necessarily, like, yeah, we give away every box. That's what we do.
How long have you been doing this show? Have I ever put that next to something in the box breaks?
I don't know
box your codes. Giveaway.
I don't know your codes.
And I said it at the beginning of the show.
Well, yeah, I was
talking at the beginning of the show. Oh, look, there's stickers in here. There's stickers.
Yeah, let's get back to this. You tell me about this product because I don't know anything about this show. Wasn't allowed to watch it as a kid. Evil, demonic.
Are you even old enough to have been on?
Yeah, I remember when it debuted.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I didn't get the big... I still don't get it. I don't understand why women find David Duchovny sexy. Or men. I don't get why anyone finds David Duchovny sexy. I like him as an actor.
Do you understand why people think Gillian Anderson was hot?
Actually, no, but I sound misogynist if I say that, so I can only comment... We're only allowed to comment on our own gender now, Rob. Didn't you know that those were the rules?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Haven't you seen...
Is this show over yet? Jeez.
Popeye Plow saying that I always forget YouTube. Come on, guys. I'm still behind here, El Guapo.
Scenes. So, yeah, supposedly there's going to be three X-Files products from Upper Deck, and each one is going to have a 300-card base set. So the master set's going to be 900 cards. Ooh, there's an alien.
So were there actually aliens on the show, or did they just go around wondering if aliens existed and chasing down hints of them?
Character insert car? No, there were definitely aliens.
In Bean We Trust is with me, the first show my parents said I couldn't watch. Well, Polio actually named their daughter Jillian, so there we go. Differences of opinion, it's why we're all here.
The unexplained phenomena. It's another insert set.
Wait, is this the one? Is this the show that had the dog and the stoner guy? And they rode around in a van?
I don't know.
Right?
I didn't start watching it till later.
Chasing aliens and ghosts and stuff.
Samantha Mulder character card. So, who hasn't had the X-Files license? I think just all versions that now fall under the Panini roof. And I don't think Fleer ever had it. Topps did. Rittenhouse Archives. Now Upper Deck.
Was Topps the original?
Wow, nice autograph. Mimi Rogers.
Hey.
Sweet signature on card of a well-known Hollywood actress. In The X-Files, she played Diana Fowley. So that's cool. Two hits in a box. No guarantee of an autograph per box, from what I understand, or maybe there is. I don't know. Did you pull that up, the product description? I don't remember.
Two single dual autographed printing plates, sketch cards in every box. So no, it does not say a guarantee of an autograph.
Nice.
Now the case hits, there's actually four case hits. Those are the redacted files insert cards. So there's... four of those per case. So keep an eye out for those as well. Wasn't Mimi Rogers the one that was married to Tom Cruise?
I honestly don't know.
Yeah. Tom Cruise's first wife. Of record.
So it went Mimi Rogers, Nicole Kidman, Katie Holmes?
Yes. Though I've heard that he interviewed a lot of other people before giving Katie the job.
Funny, James. So is Upper Deck, what are the chat room saying? Where's my X-Files fans? Is Upper Deck doing a good job with this product? They like what they see so far?
Before you even asked that, Carrie Sunvold said cool card on whatever was on the screen at that point. Mostly nice. They've been talking about, I sort of set off in motion the discussion of what your parents wouldn't let you watch.
Oh, gotcha.
Popeye Plow wasn't allowed to watch Ren and Stimpy.
I got busted watching Animal House.
The stoner with the van was Jay and Silent Bob. also, another.
But you said it was, you said with a dog, right?
Yeah, I was talking about Scooby-Doo. Yeah, sorry. I was looking at Mimi Rogers to see if she's on Twitter for me to tag in our tweet, because I'm going to go ahead and post that, because I don't know that we could get a better boom. If we do, heck, you're just going to have to enter twice to win each one. Yeah, I'm going to go post that hit right now.
More stickers. I always like seeing what I like it when entertainment properties change hands, because I like seeing what a different company's take on things is. So instead of an episodic, you know, season by season release, you know, Upper Deck is focusing on themes. And so they've also picked up the Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. license, but instead of going back and doing a season by season, they're going to do like a compendium of the entire show, which I can appreciate as well. So some cool things going on.
I can appreciate a compendium. I've always got time for a little compendium or two.
Oh, we got a case hit. We got a red redacted. Ooh. John Wayne Gacy card from Chicago. John Wayne Gacy killed 33 young men between 1972 and 1978. I totally remember this. Burying them in the crawl space beneath his house. He was often seen at neighborhood parties dressed as Patches the Clown and frequently lured victims to his home with the promise of work. Gacy was convicted in March 1980 for 12 of the killings and received the death penalty for his crimes. He was executed on May 10th, 1994.
Wow. Now that's a heck of a card back for starters.
No doubt. And that's when you, man, the good old days when you could execute people inside of 14 years. None of this 30-year appeal process.
And then
check
wait,
this
what,
out.
So yeah,
it's
what
a,
is
it's a cut document.
So it actually is a document from what is that? Like a from a file from the police report?
I have no way of knowing. I don't.
Does it say on the back?
I think
at
this
all?
Is. I think this is a manufactured like relic, or is it an actual prop from the show? It can't be the prop from a show. It would,
well,
because
that was a real story. Like that wasn't John Wayne.
No, this was like legit. Like, so, yeah,
John
I don't
Wayne
remember
Gacy
how this
wasn't actually on the yeah. show ever was he?
No, dude, there was so many shows. I have no idea. We need an X-Files expert.
Or just at least Chris Carlin to jump on and tell us about these redacted files things. Sift through public records and the redacted files insert. That's all it says.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting it to be a...
public, but it says public records, so I'm imagining that it's actually a real-life thing. The one on the sell sheet is Roswell UFO, July 8th, 1947.
So are these really documents obtained by the Freedom of Information Act and then cut up? Come on, it would say that on the back, though, wouldn't it? You wouldn't leave that terminology off.
I don't know, but that's pretty cool.
Yeah, you wouldn't. You wouldn't leave that off.
Someone's saying that the clown aspect and John Wayne Gacy were in the show, so maybe that's why they chose to include it here. But anyways, well, that's we're uncovering the mystery.
That continues and always will be.
Yeah.
X-Files.
And this is probably going to be the most popular tweet about Mimi Rogers today if you go out to GoGTS Live.
Oh, my gosh. We got a hot box. Not only did we get a case hit, we got a second autograph, this one of Kevin McNulty as Agent Brian Fuller.
Wow. That's very cool. Giving it all away or saving some for a prize pack?
We'll give those two autos away for sure.
You think those are that's better than the John Wayne Gacy? I'm really intrigued by that card as well. That's fine. Don't worry. Kevin McNulty. I forget how tightly I'm cropped, so when I go to write something, it looks like dirty work is going on over here. Wow. So, Rob, as a fan of the show, how are you enjoying these cards?
Well, you know what? This is one. If this series was on right now, it would be must-watch viewing. But, you know, I was in my early 20s. I was partying, man. I didn't care what was on TV. So, like I said, I caught some of the later seasons, or if it was on and I was happened to be home, you know, I'd watch it. So I can't, I'm not, you know, I'm flipping through X-Files here fan. And it's not, you know, instantly recognizable. But I've loved the stuff that's come out recently. So I've debated going back, but that's a lot of binge watching. I mean, what, like, I don't know, 12 seasons of X-Files. Well, that I haven't seen probably 10. Yeah, that's a lot of binge watching.
I like it, Rob. The punching bagness continues slightly, not entirely, but Alex Kent points out, I didn't get invited to parties, LOL, so I watched X-Files. And I was thinking the same thing, even though not with X-Files, but I'm like, yeah, you know, when I was 20, I was binge watching TV shows instead of going out to parties. So we know who the cool kid is here. He's the guy right below me, the voice of the collector at VOTC. Give him some love. Polio 55 says that they've seen every episode and these cards look awesome.
That's what I wanted to hear. That's great. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Amy Hood in Facebook also, she mentions her bestie and her were so obsessed with the show, we'd call off work if we got scheduled on X-Files night. So,
do they want to see a second box opened?
I mean, sure, I guess. I don't know. I don't have anything better to do.
All right.
YouTube up next is saying that up next is comedian Jeff Allen at Alive Wesleyan Church. So, yeah, let's make this episode go as long as possible because I don't want to have to watch a comedian do a church act, for better or for worse. Only Pete Holmes. He's the only Christian comedian I'll jump in on.
All right, we'll bust the seal on this one. No saving anything.
Pete Holmes who is that guy that used to do the parody songs like Weird Al, but for Christians?
Oops. I'm seeing a bunch of doubles already.
Well, how big is the base set?
300 cards. And I saw two doubles right away from that I already saw in the first box.
There's 100 unique sticker cards.
That's fun. Yeah, more unexplained phenomena inserts. I kind of like the way the recent X-Files finished up. Nice. Another good actor, Matthew Walker as Arlinsky. I'm surprised. I'm happy I knew all three of those people.
Put that on the list here.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I think that's a product at the end of the day is only as good as their autograph signing list, arguably. You know, you can say, hey, these base cards are cool, but it'll just sit on the shelf if you don't have some demand. And you've already mentioned, right, this has dual Mulder Scully autographs.
Yeah, wouldn't that be amazing? But, you know, a lot of times you open an entertainment product and I'm like, what episode were they in? Oh my gosh. Wow, boom, sketch card.
Yeah, again, I don't get the appeal of this guy. What do women see in it?
All right.
But it is a pretty good sketch card.
Kalen Archer is the artist. K-A-L-L-A-N. Kalen Archer. Thank you for spelling your name. You know, this came up in the distributor meeting. Mark Lowry. It would be nice if sketch card artists, when they sign, would also spell their name so we can, or if it can be pre-printed on the card. The Richard P. McWilliam family. The Upper Deck Company. So we will give that away.
Thank you, Rob. Mm-hmm. All right, so three autos and a sketch card to give away. If you are just now tuning in because you saw a tweet about this, make sure that you go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive and retweet the tweet. That's how you enter to win. Now, you must be watching to win. You have to stick around throughout the show to win this card from the Upper Deck Company and the Richard P. McWilliam family.
Stickers. All right, so
Seth Ward pointing out and reminding, at least you could actually pull the dual in this product. I guess unlike the last company had it as a box case incentive.
Yes, a pretty hefty case incentive.
But then it just goes to the store owner or the. I mean, do they sell? Do some of those companies sell individual cases to collectors? Is that how that worked, or
no? They have direct accounts, but not at the non B2B level.
So pretty much store owners were the only ones getting the dual autograph card.
Correct. You have a chance to pack pull one in Upper Deck X Files. Ooh, dead alien. Aw, poor alien. Sticker with backs. You gotta appreciate that. You're just taking the cheap route. Ooh, more dead aliens. Or is that the same alien from a different angle?
God, my mute button is not working properly today. Every time I press it, apparently it's not muting, and then when I don't press it, it just randomly mutes me. So I apologize for the typing that y'all just had to encounter, but that's because I'm also responsible for sending out tweets in the middle of the show. This is a multimedia experience.
Yeah, we haven't been able to fill James's past role of associate producer who would handle all that while Ivan was talking.
You know what's really funny? So I just said that, and you just brought it up. And in, I go back to my personal Twitter feed, and I see a tweet from NGT Collectibles sharing the link, telling people to check out this and the X-Files cards from Upper Deck Sports. How cool is that? See, you know what? I wouldn't have to tweet in the middle of the show if more people like NGT Collectibles existed. That's really cool. Thank you, NGT Collectibles, for doing that. It's actually pretty easy. You know, most social media platforms, wherever you're watching, generally has a little share button. All you got to do is click share on that, and you can write your own unique tweet. If you're on Periscope, just screenshot it. Give us those hearts, because that makes it get fed into more people's feeds. So thank you. Thank you. I'm a little tired today, you know. I mean, and we're both a little grumpy, clearly. So is it too much to ask just, you know, for you guys help us run the show. Help us get more peeps. We're about to open a box of Panini USA Stars and Stripes baseball cards, which is going to have 5 hits in it.
You know, there was a pretty big prospect auto that we pulled out of that product the last time we opened it that I don't think we even realized when we pulled it how hot it was. Was it CJ Abrams or something like that? Do you remember?
I think so. I'm trying to go back through my notes, but
apparently that kid's got a future. There were some people pretty excited when they saw that card. In utero.
No, sadly, it was. I've been mixing legal pads, and I actually just last weekend ripped out a bunch of pages of old giveaway winners and threw them away, and I think it was on that one. So, sorry. There's no more record of you having ever won anything if you did, so. Hey, Matthew Balsley just did it too.
You know, there was something I meant to put on Hobby Happenings, and I forgot.
Didn't happen then. If GoGTS Live didn't say it, it didn't happen.
Rick and Morty Season 2 trading cards from Cryptozoic now has a firm release date, and I believe it's April 17th. When I don't have cards in my hands, I can check, because I know a lot of you have been asking about Rick and Morty Season 2. And I saw the first promo card for Cryptozoic's new super premium product, CZX, DC Heroes and Villains, promo cards randomly inserted into NSU Magazine. That's going to be a nice product. Can't wait to see that. I would love to pull an auto of the Smoking Man. But, unfortunately, that was our last pack. But I think we did pretty good. In 2 boxes, we've got 3 autographs and a sketch card. Not too shabby. Not too shabby.
There we go. Pennywise just shared the Periscope broadcast. Y'all didn't even know I was in there watching the Periscope comments. Yep, multitasking. I'm up to 4 streams right now. First and person to guess the stream I'm not watching.
And eating? Or is that James?
No, that's James.
Oh, okay.
No, it was me. Am I still muted, James?
All right.
James, can you hear me?
So we're going to give away all 4 of those, and then do please remember the Kyrie Irving auto. Okay, what's next? Oh, yeah, Panini Stars and Stripes Baseball. This is a hit-per-pack product.
5 packs. It's going to be lots of fun, a little bit quick. And as we talked about last time we opened a box of this, there's also alumni signatures. So there are players like
Casey Mize. Which I've never pulled. I want that streak to end tonight.
Roger Clemens, Todd Helton. You know, and I feel bad. So last time we did this, I talked about how I pulled a Hunter Green autograph in a box of Stars and Stripes.
You jinxed him, dude.
Yeah, Tommy John surgery. Sad, sad, sad. Hopefully he'll come back strong. You know, guys are doing that.
Yeah, you know what?
It
isn't what it used to be.
Yeah. But, you know, I love him because he's from Southern California, from L.A. County here, and he's actually already been doing stuff to give back and to support collectors. Like, the combination of those two things that he's been doing has been crazy.
Tyler Callahan.
So I really hope he comes back strong and succeeds.
Steel Walker.
As Rob said, we may not know who the person is that we pull from this. We may not recognize their name. That does not mean that they are not a hot card.
Carson Bowen.
In the pipeline.
Spencer Torkelson. Longevity Parallel. Jacob Medor. And a jumbo swatch auto of Avery Short, left-handed pitcher.
Those pitchers.
Well, when we were first pregnant with our first child and people were like, well, what are you hoping to have? I would always answer, a left-handed relief pitcher.
Did you get one?
No.
Are either of your children lefties?
No. Which, I mean, my wife is left-handed, so it wasn't like we didn't have a shot. Davis Diaz. Longevity Parallel Graham Stinson. And an on-card autograph number to 499 of Will Wilson. Will Wilson.
Hold on a second on that.
Oh, I feel a chubber in here. Did you get it?
No, because I thought you switched up, so I switched
up.
Give me two more seconds. I see that now. Okay, I got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Timmy Manning. Braden Schwackme.
Do a little data study on that.
Haley Lansville.
Will. North Carolina, plays for the Wolfcats. Oh, I got to sign in to Baseball America to get this information. Sounds like he's pretty highly touted. Number 28 MLB draft prospect for this year, according to another site.
Did we find out if Jack Leiter is any relation to Al? Is this his son?
I believe it. We specifically found out.
It isn't, right?
Wait, no, I'm conflating him with the...
Because this one, Johnson. I mean, that...
That looks like
him. Tell me there's not a striking resemblance to Al Leiter here.
I feel like he is, and we're just conflating him with the son of former big league left-hander.
Okay, yeah, I was
like, last week we had a what's his name, Johnson. Give me the
right.
What's his name?
This one's numbered at 299.
Played in the perfect game, the USA perfect.
That's
game.
That's cool.
Performed strong in the Tournament of Stars. Looks like he's a righty though. His dad was a lefty.
As they say, he's got strong pedigree. Tanner Burns. There he is. I was right. CJ Abrams was the auto we pulled. This kid's supposed to be the real deal. Jared Kelly. Not a longevity parallel, but this parallel is a USA parallel numbered to just 25.
Ooh, Tristan Casas, Boston Red Sox.
This is a longevity parallel. Max Meyer. And we have a jumbo jersey silhouette auto numbered to 199 of Pete Crow Armstrong. Pete Crow Armstrong.
Crow Armstrong.
Jake McCarthy.
He actually goes to Harvard Westlake, just up the street from me. I could go get him to sign the other side of that card.
Bring him on as a guest. Ambush him.
High school junior, already committed to Vanderbilt, who we all know has seen many appearances in the College World Series. Great baseball school.
Didn't Dansby Swanson come out of Vanderbilt? 2019 checklist.
Can really swing the bat. Good David power Price. Potential.
Nick Madrigal. Ooh, beautiful patch. Numbered to just 16 of 23 of Max Ragic. Look at that patch.
With the auto.
Sweet. Numbered to 23. Jay Cutler went to Vanderbilt. All right, so I have no problem if we want to give all five of those away.
All right. So we got Pete Crow Armstrong. We got Jack Leiter.
Yes.
We got Will Wilson.
We got
Max Luka Doncic.
You got Leiter.
And then what's Wilson. The last, that pitcher?
Avery Short.
All right. Awesome. Yeah, these are super fun. Someone just said might need to get a box or two of these. These are super fun. Very low price point relative to some other prospect products. Lots of good autos. And one
current
of the things
SRP
I
is 75 bucks on that.
Yeah, the autos are somewhat agnostic if you happen to be an American, at least. You're not dealing with Photoshopped logos or anything like that if you have an issue with it. I don't always myself. I like Elite
Extra Edition. Oh, that's right. Out of the last box, we pulled a Japanese player with a caricature signature.
Yeah, they did this year in this product.
Japanese College All-Stars, right?
They brought in the Japanese... for autographs as well, but that's, you know, one of five autographs. It's not going to offend you.
Well, no doubt. And imagine if one day one of those guys is the next Otani or Ichiro and you're holding on to his first U.S. distributed autograph.
Yeah. So very cool. Thank you, Panini, for sharing those with us and letting us share those with all of you. Just a reminder, keep an eye out in 2 minutes on the Twitter feed for GoGTS Live. That's where you're going to have the tweet that you can retweet to enter to win any of those five hits. And so, Rob, I'm totally confused, though. Are we opening a box of Marvel Annual as well, or are we just giving one away?
We're just going to give one away.
Oh.
To those 10 people. Oh, you do? All right, hold on. Let me get another box.
Another box? What are you, Mary Poppins? That should be your new handle, Rob Mary Poppins.
Sorry, James. Go back to the box break cam.
Oh, look at this.
You want to see more?
The Mary Poppins of the hobby. He went from being the voice of the collector to being the Mary Poppins of the hobby. You down with that?
I'm down with OPP. All right. Okay, so we will open a box and give a box of Marvel Annual away. Does that make you happy?
I'm ecstatic.
All right. I'm just full of surprises tonight, aren't I? Get a double dose of X-Files. An unplanned break of Marvel Annual. And I got, next week, I can tell you, I've got a FedEx notification from Susan LaJudai at Tops. Package is being delivered tomorrow, so I guarantee we'll be breaking something from Tops next week.
I Can't wait for Hot in the Shop so we can find out what comes out next week and maybe have an idea of what we might be.
Oh, no, that's not how Topps rolls. This will be something that got released probably at least a month ago.
Such pessimism. So
we have to look back.
Who knows? Who knows?
Chances are, I'm really just hoping there's at least a box of Inception baseball in there.
Oh, I was going to say, I'd be hoping there's a box of Allen and Ginter in there. Grady Malachowski.
Dream on.
In all caps again says, and you said Rob was grumpy. Touche, Grady. Touche. Look at how gracious Rob is being, giving away an entire box of Marvel Annual.
Road as to well Infinity as, Wars.
Ooh, that's a cool looking card.
Yeah.
As well as the hits.
Infinity War insert is cool. So,
But that's funny. Okay. Give me just a second.
What do you need?
Well, I wanted to find out what the hits could be. Little internal error on the Marvel Annual. It's going to take me just a minute. At GoGTS.net, I'm typing Marvel Annual into the search bar. Did you know about GoGTS.net?
Heard something about it. Pretty good resource. Yeah. Lots of unique content.
Yeah. In fact, I just found a trading card checklist for this Marvel Annual product.
Rookie Heroes. What's her name? Where's my glasses?
We're looking for one manufactured Trenary. Patch or original sketch card. Canary? She's a rookie this year?
Trenary.
Oh, Trenary. Okay. I was going to say, Canary's been...
So I saw Captain Marvel this past weekend. Did you see it yet?
I did not. No spoilers.
I'm just going to say it right now. I thought Brie Larson crushed it. Doctor Strange Infinity Wars.
You know who really crushed it? You see the movie Incredibles 2?
Yes.
The Crusher. He crushed it, man.
Ooh.
Played by Phil LaMarr, by the way, famous voice actor in voice acting circles. Phil LaMarr was also on Pee-wee's Playhouse. He replaced.
That's not acting. That's not acting. That's voice reading. No. If wrestling isn't sports, reading from a script is not acting.
That's what all actors do. You saying Jack Nicholson's not an actor?
It's right in front of them.
Yeah.
Real actors memorize. Voice actors have it right in front of them.
You're saying Jack Nicholson isn't an actor. Earpiece. His last 10 movies, earpiece.
Wow. No, I'm making a point. I get it. No, I truly do in the sense that they are. I mean, if there wasn't inflection in their voice and, you know, the ability to act it out and blah, 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 I get that. Don't you ever tell me that wrestling isn't a sport.
I'm going to introduce you to my buddy that writes for the WWE.
Oh, dude, I didn't say it's not scripted and all fake. But the athleticism is without denial.
Steven's Collectibles for the win. Voice work is harder. Harder. Because you're usually by yourself in a booth. You don't have the other actor to work off of. You don't have any environment to
totally
work off of.
Oh, I know. I'm totally BSing you. I'm saying that you can just as easily say one thing that you did as you can what I just did. There's a direct parallel there.
Oh, parallels. We love parallels. This is the hobby. It's firing up.
Man, there's a lot of packs in a box.
People didn't know what they were in for tonight. They didn't know that when we open multiple boxes of base-focused products, they get catty Robin Ivan.
This is purple or pink foil parallel, but no numbering. I don't like that.
You know, we might have just gotten the comment of the day, which would be Spy on Sports and YouTube saying wrestling equals athletic acting.
There you go.
Just tied it all together. Brought it all together.
No, I mean, of our Circus Soleil, are they athletes? Well, this goes, man, this goes back to some conversations we used to have on Cardboard Connection Radio where, like, all right, billiards is not a sport. It's a game. But then Russ took it to the point that race car drivers are not athletes. And I went nuts. I'm like, dude, they lose like a third of their body weight in sweat during a race. Come on.
Hey, I don't know how much snooker you've watched. I've seen those guys lose hair. You can literally watch it falling out as they're trying to line up.
No, I think billiards, ping pong, curling, I'm sorry, those are games. Can you please tell me how a curler trains besides playing the same thing over and over and over again?
It's the very top part. It is a skill. A game does not require a skill, a physical skill. Anyone can play it, but not anyone can win. It requires a tremendous amount of skill.
It's still a game. Tell me bowling is not a game.
Yeah, football's a game too.
You bowl games.
But it becomes a sport when it requires a certain skill that not... Well, you or I can play snooker. You or I can play football. It's a sport because in order to be successful, it requires a tremendous amount of skill that has to be developed over time.
This was something else that came up in the... well, first, before I...
Wikipedia say is this, the answer. Well, wait, sorry. I'm only talking about snooker. I'm not talking about pool. So
eight ball.
Yeah, so ball. We could.
All right, so this is a beautiful ball. Manufactured patch card. I had to. The name down there in the bottom left-hand corner is really hard to see, and that's probably my only knock on this product. But this is Blink, and it's beautiful. Look at that.
I thought you were going to say Blink, and you'll miss it. No blinking, you'll miss it. Nada. That one's not doing it for you. Golf is a sport.
Golf is a sport only if you walk. Other than that, it's just a game.
It's literally the hitting of the ball is like 100% skill, talent, and like physical skill and talent.
Archery or riflery, James says.
Sport. Well,
my daughter is an archer, so definite skill. Is it a sport?
It requires strength. It requires steadiness. It requires precision eyesight. Yeah, if you're a hunter, James just asked, is it a sport or does it become a sport? And yeah, absolutely. If the target can kill you, you bet your ass it's a sport.
I think my problem is that, you know, for me, the only sport is hockey. So everything else just pales in comparison.
Where'd my chips go? That's all I have to say to that. Don't mute me.
Maximus. In memoriam. That means he died, and now you know. Hey, let's look at Blink on a card and compare her to her dude. Stop it right now. That's not cool. Yeah, I can hear it, and it's annoying as hell.
How can you hear me? You literally heard that, Rob?
The whole thing.
That's crazy, because I actually muted my microphone, not my... You know what? I think this is the Skype somehow picking up not my microphone. That's what it is. I'm so sorry.
I think we figured out what the audio problems with our guests have been. Whoa, back to back, but one's a red parallel.
Well, except that you also, there wouldn't be the same audio because it's in my earphones. It's not. So there wouldn't be feedback coming up there, but.
Are you eating on camera? Is the camera on you and you're eating?
Yeah, of course.
Really? That's not too bush league.
It was an expression of exasperation about you saying that hockey was the only sport.
Come on, dude. I work for a sports and entertainment company. You know I'm being facetious.
I know, and you know I'm being facetious with my expression of exasperation, but come on, hockey is the only sport? Hey, Dodgers Dennis just tuned in on YouTube. Good to see you, man. Jumping in after putting the kids to bed, he says.
There's Mary Jane.
I was right in the middle of composing a tweet about this, too.
All right, so it's just hits one hit?
Upper deck. Yeah,
one hit per box?
Yeah, one hit guaranteed per box. So.
Well, then in that case, it is the Blink manufactured patch card. We'll give that away. I'm going to be gone this weekend, though, so I won't get to any shipping until after I get back at best. So whoever wins, don't email us wondering where your stuff is. You'll get it when I get it out to you. All right.
So go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive to enter to win, to hit that awesome manufactured patch card. If you want a chance to win the Kyrie Irving that went unclaimed, the autograph of Kyrie Irving from last night, retweet our pinned tweet, the Periscope broadcast, and go tag some friends and tell them that you're watching the show. We've still got more hobby news, notes, happenings, and some interesting fun stuff from Rob, the collector himself, coming up on the program.
All right, then. So let's take a look at what's hitting store shelves next week in the hobby with Hot in the Shop. Kicking things off, we have 2018 Panini Honors NFL football cards as the waning days of the 2018 collecting season come to a close here in a few months. Two autograph cards and two base cards in every box. It's funny, I remember when Honors was like a 24-pack product. Now it's a one-pack product with four cards. Two of them are autographs. It returns this year with more on-card autographs than ever before, and every card in Honors will be numbered to 99 or less, unless it's a buyback card. What? Yep, there are autographed buyback cards in here, including... Yeah, guys like Barry Sanders. So that's pretty cool. Ooh. Find updated autograph versions of some of the most iconic cards of all time. Hey, I just said that. 1989 score Barry Sanders. 1990 score Emmett Smith. 2000 score preview Tom Brady. 2001 score select Drew Brees, and many, many more. Look for graded buybacks of players like Walter Payton. Yes, sweetness. Johnny Unitas, Bart Starr, Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, Reggie White, rest in peace, Jerry Rice, Randy Moss, Dan Marino, John Elway, Drew Brees, and Bill Belichick. Updated base and autograph versions of top rookies from 2018 score and classics on premium Optichrome technology. That's cool. Multiple parallels. Honors base signatures. 32 cards from the base set will have an autograph version. Recollection collection, all signed on card, and originals, autos, as we mentioned, over 100 original graded cards. Hitting store shelves next Friday.
Hey, Rob, you knew it was bound to happen this year. Shohei Ohtani gracing the cover of a baseball card product. On the box right there. Yes, that's right. 2019 Panini Diamond Kings baseball cards comes to us. bringing the incredible artwork look of Diamond Kings, along with the framed cards, memorabilia, and the first autographed memorabilia cards of the 2019 rookie class in Diamond Kings material signatures. Each box is going to have one autographed and one memorabilia card, plus three of those aforementioned framed parallels, as well as a number of potential other parallels. You're going to have the artist proof and 12 additional inserts. So a fun base set to collect. DK signatures with four parallels numbered to 99 or less with some incredible color, artwork, rainbow looks to them. And again, the DK material signatures and bringing back retro 1983 signatures, a throwback to 1983. These cards pair an autograph along with two pieces of memorabilia from former stars and legends. Those flashback cards that you see there, an incredible looking insert set. The DK and 1919 insert set paying homage to some of the great players of 1919. There's going to be the 300 paying homage to 10 of the greatest pitchers in baseball who have achieved that career gold standard of 300 wins. And then finally, DK 205 signatures featuring current and retired stars on cards based on the timeless T205 designs. Oh, yeah, and maybe some Material Cuts Masterpiece signatures with bits from guys like Babe Ruth. Absolutely great product. If you want more details, go to GoGTS.net. This hits store shelves next week.
Honestly, did we already talk about this next product last week or the week before last? 2019 Leaf Metal Draft Football.
Looks familiar.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to...
this week?
Oh, we did the retail. All right. So this is hobby and jumbo, which means if you heard me right, jumbo, new configuration this year. So hobby's going to deliver five autograph cards signed on card in every hobby box. The jumbo is going to deliver nine autos signed on card, but that's not all. Oh, no, no, no. Jumbos are going to have a slabbed clear proof autograph card numbered 1 of 1 in every jumbo box. Again, this release is going to focus heavily on the best offensive skill position players and potential future defensive stars. In addition, look for numerous low numbered prismatic parallels and prismatic wave inserts. When you pee, you puh the mic a little bit. Prismatic. So this is going to be in shops next week, and it's loaded with all your potential top draft picks. Despite this class being a little bit weaker than in years past that we've gotten spoiled on, guarantee you there's going to be some stars coming out of it. So this is a great way to jump in on one of the early draft products of the year.
Awesome. Hey, Rob, let's take it to the pitch. That's right. For the greatest sport there is, 2018-19 Donruss soccer cards.
Soccer's not a sport.
Coming to us from Panini. Incredible sport. These guys lose more weight in they never have the weight to lose. That's how incredibly toned they are. This great-looking product, it's going to cover worldwide soccer. So you're going to have some names like Lionel Messi, Luka, not Doncic, Luka Modric from Croatia, the runners-up in last year's World Cup, Christian Pulisic, Cristiano Ronaldo, and many, many more. It's going to showcase the best players from 30 of the most prominent club and national soccer teams around the world. Each box is going to contain two autographed cards along with rated rookies. Fun chance to see the rated rookies logo on some brand new soccer stars, along with inserts like the beautiful game autographs, a beloved feature of Donruss Soccer since its first release in 2015, including some of the biggest names of soccer's present and past, as well as hobby-only dual, triple, and quad autographs on that beautiful game format, as well as Road to France autographs. Look forward to the USA's quest for a fourth women's world soccer title with Road to France autographs. All the best of the U.S. women's national team are here, from Carly Lloyd and Alex Morgan to Julie Ertz and Tobin Heath. Very cool that they're getting their due in this worldwide soccer product, because Team USA women deserve it. along with all kinds of parallels, rainbows, exciting hobby-only optochrome inserts. Lots to build with this set. Check out 2018-19 Donruss soccer cards in shops this week.
And last, but certainly not least, coming off of WrestleMania 35 will be 2019 Topps WWE Raw trading cards. Some people have been wondering, where is the Topps WWE flagship product? Well, here's the deal. It's been rebranded to showcase the separate rosters of Raw and SmackDown Live, with SmackDown Live releasing later in 2019. Typical configuration as far as a pack out though goes, you're going to be getting two hits in a box, one being a guaranteed autograph. You're going to get 24 packs. Each one of those is going to have an insert card. Multiple parallels throughout, featuring the entire men and women's roster of Raw and the Cruiserweight division from 205 live on the WWE Network. Also look for triple autograph cards and that additional hit, relic card, kiss card, printing plate, matte relics, combinations of inserts, three new ones, Hometown Heroes, Legends of Raw, and the second part series of the Ronda Rousey Spotlight, a 90 card base set with parallels numbered from 99 down to 1 of 1. That's a look at what's hot in the shop. All right, circling back to the GoGTS Live Q of the Week poll, and thank you for all 237 people who voiced their opinion. And 36% just can't get enough Major League Baseball. So whatever your sport, I hope you do have a great weekend soaking it all in. All right. So while Ivan pulls some winners from our numerous surprise giveaways, or I should say unplanned, you know, that guy at Watch the Breaks, he's always showing off his mail days on Periscope and whatnot. Well, you know what? Rob gets mail days too sometimes. I happened to get one last week from our very own viewer, Seth Ward, and wanted to show off some of my goods. I collected the gold parallel set of Notre Dame 1988 championship on EPAC, as well as some of the autographs, and he sent me 5 autograph cards I did not have. How cool is that? He sent me from Leaf. One of the great things about Leaf is that even though they can't show logos, it doesn't matter. Notre Dame doesn't have a logo on their helmet. So there's Mike McGlinchey. And then talk about somebody who knows me. Look at these Matt relic cards, including some low numbered ones, but this one's of Ember Moon, numbered to 199. There she is, the now retired Brie Bella. There's Carmella, numbered to 199. Naomi, numbered to just 99. A duel of Bailey, and this one's numbered to just 50. Another one of Carmella, this one to 25. And then 3 X-Files cards from previous releases. So thank you again, Seth Ward. You obviously have know me well and have been watching from the very beginning. So that was
good guy.
Yeah, that was much appreciated and quite the surprise. But then another package showed up this week. This one from viewer Michael McManus.
Hey.
I haven't even had the chance to open this one yet, so I'm going to do that right now.
Let's hope it's not a what was the best thing we ever gave away? The Teletubbies.
Oh yeah, let me put that down here just in case. No, it looks like there's actually Teletubbies. Yo Gabba Gabba.
Yeah, we once had a our trade or no trade segment, and a viewer Oz in Australia won a Yoga Gabba.
Nice. Look at that. One of the 1993 Pacific Prism graded cards of Jim Harbaugh.
Ooh, I like that.
That is cool. What else is in here? Oh man, is this a transcendent? Is this a transcendent card? Come on.
Wow. At JG Fan Forever.
Are you kidding me, Michael?
Is Michael's handle if you're not following him on Twitter.
Frank Thomas.
Wow.
That's awesome.
What's that number to? Just like 85, 65? It's got a number on
it. This one was 83 was the number. This was the first year. Wow. And then three sweet Thomas cards, including this beautiful acetate card. We were just talking about this. This one's numbered to 3,000 when that was like considered low. Remember those days? That's awesome. Dude, thank you so much. But there's another little sealed team bag in here. We've got an Anthony Miller jersey card, as well as a couple base cards of him and Rokon Smith. Rookie That's wave.
Cool. Man.
And an autographed card of Ray Serge from the White Sox. So, wow. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Michael McManus and Seth Ward. That's really, really cool of you guys. I didn't have any video content to put into this time slot. So thank you for indulging me, listeners, showing you a personal mail day and giving a fun shout out to two of our loyal viewers from the very beginning. So thanks, guys.
It's just really too bad because McManus, that was actually an incredible mail day. You just didn't include one guy that actually plays a sport, though. That's...
Oh, too funny. All right.
No, that was actually really cool. How'd you do? I hope Michael McManus is watching because, ironically, I actually pulled his name as before you even mentioned you had a package from him. So, Michael McManus, I hope you're watching because you do have to tell us what you won. But we did well. We got lots of winners, got some new names, got some old names, got some old viewers that haven't won in a while. So this is going to be a fun one. To start it all off, remember, always retweet the Periscope tweet. Maybe every once in a while we won't have a prize for it, but today we had two prizes for that. The first one going to any viewer who retweeted the Periscope tweet on our Twitter feed. And if you hear your name, the way you get your prize is you email the show. It's down there in the lower left of your screen. GoGTS Live@GoGTS.net. And just a reminder, GoGTS.net is the website you should be using as your hobby resource for checklists, content, future watch articles, all of those things. I'm not going to say anything about any other websites, but I do know that the people that run GoGTS.net care about you, love you, are good people, decent people. So that said, the first winner that needs to email that is of the Kyrie Irving that went unclaimed last week. How crazy is that? Make sure if you're a new viewer, email us. That is going to BT Hawks. Congratulations, BT Hawks. Way to go. Hawks as in Seahawks up there in Seattle. I'm noticing some lag, so I'll repeat things a little bit every once in a while. So BT Hawks, congrats on winning that. Next up, the Marvel box, the unopened Marvel box. Well, there were only 10 names pulled that ended up being eligible, but it was also entered by retweeting the Periscope tweet. And we pulled for that name, for that box, Jimmy Bayless. Congratulations, Jimmy, in Michigan, who grills in the snow. You'll be winning that box. Next up, out of X-Files, we've got the sketch card, one of one sketch card with the art written and signed. Thank you, artist and Upper Deck, for doing that. Of Mulder, Scully, Mulder. Which one is that?
Mulder. Fox Mulder.
Mulder is going to In Wood We Trust. Hope that you are an X-Files fan. Don't tell me what you end up doing with that sexy, sexy picture of David Duchovny. Next up, the Matt Walker auto from our second box. And thank you, Upper Deck Sports and Entertainment, for sending us two boxes of this. Lots of fun watching that be broken. Matt Walker auto is going to Josh Kidwell. Congratulations, Josh. And then the Kevin McNulty auto. Yep, McNulty, like The Wire. A lot of y'all said that. Not that this actor was actually in The Wire. But that goes to Troy Beach. Congratulations, Troy. And then the Mimi Rogers auto is going to Jason Rocco. Jason Rocco, I'll repeat it twice just in case there's a hiccup in the stream. But Jason, you know how to claim your prize. Go ahead and do that. All right. Switching gears to baseball, that incredible Stars and Stripes box. That was a lot of fun. Some great looking patches and some great looking autographs. Let's start off with Jack Leiter, the son of Al Leiter. Jack Leiter. That one is going to Clint Mason. Congratulations, Clint, for winning the Jack Leiter. Way to go. Next up, the Pete Crow Armstrong, the guy from Harvard Westlake right here in sunny California. That's going to McManus. That's the Michael McManus right there. Congratulations, McManus. Good timing watching the show tonight. And that was a really cool mail day for Rob. Next up, Will Wilson. Hey, that's going to my friend, all caps, Grady Malachowski. Grady, all caps Malachowski with the Will Wilson win. Congratulations. And then the Max Reichich. That's going to Josh. Josh doesn't have a last name, according to Twitter. He is in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, though. So that's how you know which Josh it is. Congratulations, Josh in Broken Arrow. Email the show to claim your prize. And then finally, Avery Short autograph is going to Chris Jordan. Congratulations, Chris Jordan. Finally, the Blink manufactured patch from Upper Deck Marvel Annual. We gave away a full box. We also opened up a box. That is going to Chai's Party 07. I know I mispronounced it the last time he won. He corrected me. It's like Chai Town, like Chicago. So Chai's Party 07. You get that Blink manufactured relic from Upper Deck Marvel Annual. Which I think being a superhero is a sport, isn't it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Couple quick things I mentioned. We'll know something about what's happening with Topps breaks when FedEx gets here tomorrow. Stay tuned for that. We will be back with a brand new episode next week. And again, thanks to Panini and Upper Deck for the packages that we received over the last week or so from you guys to be able to share with our audience. One quick note, we did have some troll on Twitter. I think
really
anybody that knows us knows that we started the show with no friends. Okay. On Twitter. So anybody who says, did you ever notice that? Like, it's really just the host's friends that like always win. And that they never show like the random, but they show like everything else. You know what, dude? Go away. Just go away. And when you see comments like that, all you people that win stuff on a regular basis, do me a favor. Troll those people and absolutely bury them. Okay? Because honestly, we don't have time for shenanigans. And I think we've proved that from the bottom of our hearts, we love to give back. So when you see stuff like that being replied to on our timeline, if you could help shut those people up and shame them mercilessly, I would be so appreciative.
Okay? I appreciate you saying that, Rob. This is another one where I feel like we do need another quick diversion to the chat room, because we've already, first off, right before you started your rant, out of nowhere, Joshua Lee Lanus, who lives in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, commented on Facebook for the first time I've ever seen his name, saying, yay. And it's like, yeah, I don't know Joshua from anyone else from Broken Arrow, but hey, I'm really glad that he was in the chat. I'm glad that he watched the show, and I'm glad that he caught that he won. We love giving stuff out. And then Amy Hood followed that up immediately with, Ivan unfriended me, and I have still won stuff, LOL. And it's 100% true. It's like, in fact, actually, ironically, I've said some people's names on here that I can't stand. But you've still won because I don't argue with the randomizer.
I wish we had
the time to plot and plan.
Yeah, I mean, we just it's just don't. And
and I don't even know who said that because I didn't see that tweet. But I would, so, you know.
I do appreciate the guys who I reached out to via DM to say something to those, that person, and they did. And to you, that person, if you're watching, thank you for watching. Keep watching. Maybe you'll win. Obviously, yeah. But you know what? If you only watch to win, you can stop watching. I want you to be knowledgeable in the hobby. I want you to be entertained by the hobby. And winning stuff along the way is just for fun. So we don't have time for games, politics, shenanigans, and BS. And I'm sorry that you do. So like I said, if you see that stuff, help us out, because we really do love giving back to you guys, because the hobby's been really good to Ivan and I, and it's our way to pay it forward. So we'll be here with a brand new episode of GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show, next week. For James Gale behind the scene, Ivan Lovgren, I'm Rob Bertrand. Have a great weekend. You know what to be doing. Always be collecting. We'll talk to you next week.
Cheerio.